This is the launch operations manager. The launch team wishes you good luck and Godspeed.
Thank you very much. No, it'll be a good one.
Let's still go at this time.
10, 9, ignition sequence starts. 6, 5, 3, 2, 1, 0, all engine running.
Just struck. Everybody, welcome back to the channel. This week I am at Watkins Glen State Park. It is one of the most popular and famous state parks in the state of New York. Thank you so much for joining me, and here we go. The park is open, sort of. The Gorge Trail, which is the most popular trail, and goes about a mile in and takes you through all the different waterfalls, that's closed. But I'm going to take a few shots here. I've got this place literally all to myself. It's crazy. But I'm going to take advantage of that. I'm going to shoot, obviously, the scene right behind me. And there's some other opportunities around. Just this whole canyon area. Kind of show it to you. There's some trees, some grassy areas over there. The light's pretty good. Got a nice overcast day, a little bit of sun peeking through. So I'm gonna spend some time here. I'm gonna see what I can do to get some nice shots here. And then there's another falls that's relatively close by called Montora Falls, and I'm gonna go shoot that too. So first things first, I'm going to shoot, this is called Sentry Bridge, I believe. I'm going to shoot this and get kind of a multi-directional falls, you know, right there behind me. Probably throw on the little stopper. It's a six-stop filter made by Lee Filters. And going to use my polarizer. So one thing about when you're out shooting waterfalls and creeks, rivers, streams, that whole thing, wet rocks, awesome, right? Gives you great saturation, gives you great depth, texture, colors, beauty, the whole thing. But it will also give you really harsh reflections off of those rocks. So that's where a polarizer comes in really handy when you're shooting wet rocks and things like that. So I'll put the polarizer on, try to take the glare off those, off the wet rocks. And we'll see. I'm pretty sure we can get some beautiful shots right back here behind me. And then we'll see what else we can get. This fence is really creating an issue, making it very challenging to get a clean image, a good composition of the falls and the bridge, the whole scene. So I'm going to shoot this from different distances. Like, I'm right up close to the bridge right now. I'm going to scoot back that way. I'm going to start here, shoot it here, scoot back that way, probably 50 meters or so, maybe 100. And I'll also shoot it from different levels. I've got an opportunity here. There's steps right here behind me, so I'll be able to shoot up at a different level too. So different distances from the focal point, different levels from the main subject. different lenses, everything. Just gonna try to work the scene until I can find a good image. So because I've got my camera in a crazy precarious position hanging over the edge, I've actually taken the camera strap off of my M50, which is what I'm vlogging on right now, and used it as a tether. I tied it onto my D850 and then tied the other end onto my tripod. So just a little safety precaution. I know they have out there, there's like safety tethers. They're metal. You can tie them into where your normal camera strap ties in. You might even be able to tie them into where the, you know, that quarter inch screw mount on the bottom of your camera where you screw on your tripod. But, and some people recommend it. I've not used it. I've just haven't. But I'll tell you what, if for some reason my camera fell off the tripod over a cliff, I sure as hell would have wished that I used one. So, something you can think about, because, you know, when I've got my camera, when I've got the D850, 99% of the time, I'm on a tripod. So I don't have a camera strap, hardly ever, on my D850. So having a tether when you're in some precarious spots, that's not a bad thing. Especially when you invest so much in a camera and lens and gear and all that. So, little tip for the day. So right now I put on my wide angle lens. I hardly ever use this lens for landscape photography. I always use it for my architectural stuff, my real estate business that I do. But I've got it out today, and it's given me a better composition, or at least it seems like it's a better composition. What I like about this composition, what I really love about this composition right now, is I've got that bridge, and I got the trees up there behind the bridge. Now I'm blowing out the sky. My filter kit doesn't fit on my wide angle lens, so I'm gonna. The sky's going to get blown out, which, you know, I'm going to live with. I'll bracket and see if I can save any of the sky. But what I really like, and I'm going to pull out in post-processing, is the bottom of the bridge up there. It's got these striations, just old, you know, weathered look underneath it, and just kind of matches, just adds a little more creaminess and texture to the bridge itself. And obviously, you know, just gives the viewer a little more anchor, a little more to grab onto when looking at the image. So that's the idea. I'm shooting at f/18, f/22. I've got the ISO cranked all the way down. That's just so I can get a slow enough shutter speed to get that silky smooth look in the water of the waterfall. So that's what I like. Really like that silky smooth look when I'm shooting waterfalls. So that's usually what I go after, and that's usually between 0.5 and 1.5 seconds. Obviously it depends on the speed of the water and the light and everything else, a lot of variables. But speaking of light, sun just popped out, so let's see what that does for us. Holding hands, Jesse James.
Okay, so this is the raw image right out of camera before post-processing. And, you know, as I look at it, I think it's a pretty good image. It's exposed pretty well. The only thing that I really wanted to fix was there's a couple of hot spots, both on the left and the right side. So I just wanted to tone those down a little bit, and I wanted to increase the exposure a little bit on the bottom of the bridge, kind of highlight that a little bit, and bring the viewer's eye towards the center. That arc in the bottom of the waterfall almost seems like an arrow, you know, pointing towards the center of the image, which is the waterfall. So, and I saw those two hotspots on the right and the left as a little bit of a distraction. I wasn't worried about the trees at the top being blurry because it was a longer exposure, and or blown out, because I thought there was a strong enough element to draw the viewer's eyes, A, towards the bridge, and then B, obviously, to the waterfall. So that's what I did. I worked on that. I used adjustment brushes and, you know, knocked down those hot spots and increased the exposure and the whites a little bit on the bottom of the bridge. So, and this is what we came up with. I guess I should feel sorry, but I for one still dream about those days when we played. Well, tragedy just struck. I'm so bummed out. Just lost my drone into that waterfall. God dang it. Something very, very bizarro happened. The drone just took off like lightning speed going straight. I was doing just a casual shot of the bridge. But when I got up there towards that bridge with the drone, it just, I don't know what happened. It just went straight, like it shot out of a cannon and flew right into literally right into the waterfall. Not good. And the thing is, it's like, I think most photographers are like this. You know, you can buy a new drone. It was a DJI Spark. It wasn't super expensive. I had some gorgeous footage from two locations, two waterfalls, Shitnango Falls and now here, Sentry Bridge. And it's gone. Gone forever. You'll never get it back. You never even see it. I'll never see it. That just sucks. God damn it. Yeah. All right. So after I lost the drone, I was bummed out for about a half hour. And packed everything up, was gonna head home, but I did recall a guy on Mally Davis's Facebook page had contacted me. He was telling me to go to Montour Falls, which is literally like 5 miles from where I was at Watkins Glen. All right, well, Watkins Glen is definitely a beautiful park, and I will be going back there as soon as I can. Actually, the whole upstate New York area is just gorgeous. I mean, with covered bridges and lakes and streams and barns and these quaint small towns everywhere you look that are just filled with history and charm and character. But the question of the day is, have you ever lost a piece of gear that had your images on it? Did you lose a camera? Did you lose a drone? Have you lost a memory card? Did you reformat the wrong card? In the comments below, let me know your feeling. What's worse, losing the gear or losing the images and or video that you'll never see ever again that was lost with that piece of gear? So that's it for this week, folks. Thank you so much for stopping by the channel. I always appreciate it. If you haven't already, please hit the old subscribe button and ring the notification bell, and you'll be notified of all the new videos when they come out. Like, comment, tell your neighbors and your friends about the channel. I'm trying to get to 1,000. Almost there, and that's a big thank you to all of you. So have a great day, have a great week, and we will see you soon. Bye-bye.